We're live here at the Stray Dog in Walthamstow, February 23rd, 2019. I'm Mike here, and I'm joined in the commentary box by Martin and Joe. And we've kicked off now. Hello. Oh.
So, very comfortable here in the commentary box. Well, a kind of metaphorical one. So this is the quarterfinals of the Anagram Records Trophy that we're watching here. Clapton managed to reach this stage by defeating Epping Forest in the first round of the competition. And then back on a very rainy day in November, they managed to defeat Letchworth Garden City, who are in the same league as Chipperfield. Oh, hang on. Chipperfield coming in with an early attempt there, but does go quite high and wide. As I was saying, Clapton did end up going through against Letchworth, who are a step above us, as are Chipperfield. So the Toms are going to have difficulty today with that. After this corner, I will quickly take you through the squad that we had on that day. Okay, so Chipperfield getting it into the centre of the box there, but it is cleared out by the defence. So, squad for Clapton on this day was in the goal. It was Vlad Bendovsky, who was making his first appearance of 2019, having had quite a few injuries in the period before. So, you have to see how rusty his legs are. Chipperfield coming back again, but still in the central area, coming across the box, being chased down to the corner there, and I think that is going to go for a corner kick. Also making their first appearance today is number two, Albie Miller, and then we have some more regular faces, Liam Smith and Yassine Rabia, Dean Buho. In the middle, we've got Jeff Ockran, Alec Coleman and Steph Nielsen, and up front, we've got Sherwin Stanley, Elliot Crosby and Lewis Avedi. So that is our Tons team today. I remember I wrote the match report for this, and I have scribbled down some of the names of the Chipperfield players. Oh! And there is an early attempt on goal. That is about the second or third good chance they've had. So it is still right down the Clapton end, and they are being pressured on the off here.
Well, that's a good save from Vlad there, and goal, putting it on the top, and it goes out for another.
The ball, yep, fished out from the bushes. Time for another corner. And here it comes. So it's crossed in, but it's scooped up by Bendovsky there, and it is going to get cleared out. If you do want to get in touch with us today, then just get in touch via Twitter. We will be checking it for, any, constructive criticism that you'd like to give. Let us know where you're watching from today. The weather here in England isn't quite as nice as it was the last time we did one of these as live matches, so hopefully there's a few more of you watching. We'd also recommend that, seeing as we're not watching football these days, if you could perhaps chuck a few quid into the kind of aid fund that we've set up for members who might be struggling at the moment due to rent, food, etc. What was the last count as to what we've raised on that now?
I believe that we're up to £4,800 and we've given around £2,000 out to members in need of assistance.
That is pretty impressive. I think to beat that, you'd need to be an old man walking around your garden. But yeah, that is pretty good. So if you can spare a few quid for that, just spend, what you would have spent at the football, essentially.
Martin, just taking it back to the present time of February the 23rd, 2019, on this beautiful sunny day in Walthamstow. Interesting to see Clapton going into this game on a real high following last week's fantastic league game, beating league leader Stonewall 5-1 in front of a record home crowd of 618. I missed that there.
It was just Sherwin chasing down a delivery, but the team got to it first.
Oh, Chipperfield took one right in the face there.
So yeah, you were saying that was the Stonewall game was the one that actually we showed about 2 weeks ago. Bit of pushing and shoving in the middle of the pitch.
Yeah, sometimes I don't know where or when I am these days.
I think that's it. It just certainly since I've been down in Sussex, everything has kind of merged into a bit of a Groundhog Day situation. Okay, so Steph, our dead ball specialist last year, making the delivery in, does go a little long though. Not able to make anything of it there. Yeah, I think this was one of the first nice days of the spring last year, actually.
This year.
A bit of that blue sky here.
The sky is blue. You know, Clapton are going into this game, they had a bit of a dodgy patch in December and early January, but they've actually scored. Oh, hang on, Chipperfield going forward again. Nicely mopped up.
Good for you.
Yeah, I was just saying that in the last three games, Clapton have scored a pretty impressive 13 goals. Oh, great save there from Vlad. Even though one of those games was a 2-1 defeat away at North West London, but I think we've maybe sort of got a good chance today with Jeff Ockren being able to field a full strength squad for 2 weeks in a row. Jeff reckons that Chipperfield are the favourites on paper, but he also said that he doesn't think Clapton have been outplayed all season, and the team are embracing the underdog tag this weekend, which caused a bit of an upset in the cup.
Well, they are certainly being pushed early on in the match here. They've had a few kind of stabs down at the Chipperfield end of the pitch, but it has been mostly with the boys in blue so far. By the way, I love the Comic Sans font on their logo. It looks very professional.
I had a brief chat to Jeff before the game, and he said that I think the pressure will definitely be on them because they're obviously the step above. As the underdogs, we can just kind of get on with it, basically, and have a bit of fun. But they've really got to come here and prove their status above us. And so far, they've had it's been kind of end to end.
Oh, and yeah, so that was. I don't know, did either of you see a leg go in there? I mean, he's been a bit limpy, but yeah. Certainly from the camera angle, that didn't look like a foul to me, but there you go.
And you've seen them given, Martin, haven't you?
Sorry?
You've seen them given, haven't you?
Have I?
Seen them given.
Well, seen them given.
We've all seen them given, haven't you, Martin?
I'm lost. I don't know what them is here. Clapton coming in, do just hit it. Well, the keeper does manage to get there. So keeper for Chipperfield today is a guy called Stuart Bedall, and he was good on the reactions there. So the Clapton corner is mopped up there by Bedell, and it's going to come back out. See if Chipperfield can do something on the break. Not able to, though.
Bit of a hoof on that one.
A little bit. So how are your quarantine periods going at the moment?
Don't know what you're talking about, mate.
Oh, well, either of you.
Well, you know, as we're in 2019, I quarantine would refer to someone being ill, but I'm a picture of health myself.
No, that is a good point. Yeah, it'd be absolute madness if we were stuck in a, stuck in our homes having to commentate on old matches, wouldn't it? I don't think I'd want to live in that world. Right, so back down Chipperfield M for another clearance. Nice long clearance deep into the box, but is mopped up by Bendovsky.
That Vlad had the first ever Clapton Community FC tattoo.
He did, yeah, on his... Chipperfield still applying the pressure.
Wide.
Yeah,
and offside.
Yeah, he got it on his calf, didn't he? He is a tattoo artist by profession, Mr. Bendovsky.
He certainly is, Martin, and he did a tattoo for me on my own calf of a spoonbill, my favourite bird.
Really?
Ah, that's cool.
Yeah, that is. Yeah, because I know he did one of our programme covers, didn't he? Tattooed his own leg. Apparently he's tattooed you as well, so, yeah. A creative man. He still comes to the odd game, doesn't he? Obviously, he now moved out of London.
I think he's back in Italy, but I have seen him once or twice.
Oh, who's cracking open a beer?
That would be me.
good call. I've just popped down to the village pub, the one with the donkey that I was talking about last time, because they're doing takeaways, so I took...
What's the donkey's name again?
It was called Becky the donkey. But, yeah, and so I just took a big jug of, one of those 6-pint milk bottles with me, and I've got that filled up. So I should be good for the match.
You got it filled up by the donkey?
Not by the donkey, no. No, the donkey gets other people to do the work. Okay, Chipperfield coming into the box, returning feet. Clapton now looking to get something on the break here. But does end up getting swept up by Bedoll. Yeah, the weather's certainly nicer than it was for the game against Lech. That was an away fixture for the that second round match, and it was back in November. Absolutely poured it down, and it was another hard fought match, really. So, similar to how this one is playing out at the moment. I remember, for some reason, the BUC decided to go and stand in the rain for the whole of the game. Not really sure what that was about, but they're sunning themselves rather nicely at this match.
That was one of the wettest games I've ever been at, but Letchworth won. But, interesting fact. On the way to the ground, we spotted a black squirrel. Have you ever seen a black squirrel?
Not in the UK, no. I studied in Ottawa, and they have loads there. But, yeah, maybe it was on its holidays.
No. There's like a colony. They like a garden.
And Miller there, on his first appearance, trying to feed them, but not quite able to get there.
Rolling up to the 15-minute mark, and one of the things that Jeff often says is that he kind of does look at the game in kind of 15-minute segments, and you know, goes into the first 15, kind of looking to see what the opposition have got. So far, I've had a couple of decent chances, and there's one there. But you wouldn't say it's entirely one way, and I think that, you know, would feel pretty confident pressing on for the rest of the match. Do you guys agree?
Personally, I think the run of play is with the Corinthians at the moment. I think they've certainly been able to make more of their chances. But, the Clapton defence is staying tight. And if they can just carry on doing that and get something on the break, then you never know.
No, I think Clapton will get a good chance today. The play is mostly Chipperfield at the moment, but I think we can get back into this. We can hold it up, and with the fans behind Clapton at home, that always helps.
And I think that does help when you're getting deep into the second half in these close matches. But
quite a tackle there from Albie Miller.
Yeah, Miller.
It's a brave, maybe.
It was a bit tasty from Albie there.
Yeah. Do you keep finding that forward man? Is it Chapman or Cutler? I can't quite see which, but they seem to find him just outside the penalty box a couple of times now.
Yeah, they've got Chapman and Cutler up front. Don't ask me which is which. All I can see are men in blue shirts. But yeah, we can say Chapman / Cutler. So Bendelski's going to clear it out now for all the Tons.
Yeah, just to follow up on that Black Squirrel story, it was in Hartford. Called in to let us know about that, or tweeted in. It was a very, very lovely experience seeing that little black squirrel as we were walking up to the ground.
Yeah, I didn't realise you had them in this country, but yeah. There you go, learned something today.
Aye.
I'll have to see if we can use it in the Clapton quiz that we do on the Tuesdays.
You learn so... Ooh. That was a bit...
I think it went down a little bit easy. Is it Jeff there? Who, no. No, it's Ellick, isn't it? Yeah.
Chaps, I'll be back in 2 seconds. I just need to grab a brownie.
That sounds important. Okay. So Chipperfield in the middle of the park. Crosby with quite a meaty tackle there, but doesn't get called out for it. Pushing forward still. Ellick on the wing. It is going out, though, for a Chipperfield throw. No, for a Chipperfield free kick even. Free kick cleared out fairly easily there from the back. Just having a bit of lob it and chase football here for the moment. And Clapton now just trying to build something up on wing. But not enough support there for it. So it is back in Chipperfield possession. Chipperfield trying to hold this in the middle of the park. Is ending up back with the boys in red and white. I wonder whether our viewer from Hertfordshire, are you watching this as a Chipperfield fan or as a Clapton fan?
Question.
Let us know. Because I know that. Ali Mummy. So I know we did end up sweeping up a few new fans when we played in was it in Letchworth? No, it wasn't Letchworth, it was Welling, wasn't it?
Clapton going forward here.
I blocked.
Oh, still got it in the edge of the box. That was a soft shot into the keeper.
Something of a P roller.
A little bit. P-roller. Yeah, because we ended up picking up a bunch of trade union fellas, didn't we, at Letchworth, who started
gym. That's right. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, they had a banner and stuff.
Oh, and it does come through, but it is stopped by Bendelski. Is it one of you guys who is telling us about squirrels? Let us know. So we've got Steph now, just out on the wing. Manages to feed it through to Ellick, but can't get the cross through. So he can't.
Noise for the stray dog.
Yeah, you see, I'm not able to hear the noise. Find any headphones, so I've had to mute the match. So, yeah, you'll have to tell me how excited the crowd are getting.
You put your fingers in your ears, Martin.
It's noise cancelling headphones, I reckon.
It would be good if I had some of those, but I don't. So yeah, you'll have to tell me if I can see Stu there at the front shaking his head. So yeah, you'll have to tell me if Stu says anything within mic shot.
Just generally, we go again.
Yeah. Usually, yeah. I do remember at some point in this game. Oh, hang on. Chipfield have a good chance here. Oh!
Over the bar.
Fires it over there. I think, he'd have had Bendovsky beat on that if it had been on target.
He's going to rue that chance.
Yeah.
Could well be.
I'm impressed at how quick they managed to fetch the ball, though, because that was fired into the hedge. So yeah, I remember when we were watching this match, as I said, I was writing the match report, so I was stood next to the benches. And I do remember their coach at some point yelling, "Come on, we should be 6-0 up by now," which I think he did say that in the first half.
It might happen.
not quite sure it was a 6-0 performance at the point where he said it, because it wasn't the time around now. But yeah, certainly having them on the play, and here they come again. Oof. And that does ring off the post, it looked like. So yeah, it did. It went off the post, so it is going to be okay.
I might now concede that they're having the better of the play.
I think he had Bendovsky beat on that. And I'm sure there are a lot of hearts in the mouths of people at the Stray Dog at the moment.
24 minutes gone. There's still a lot of time to play.
There was some rumour that Chipperfield had been viewing our YouTube footage for kind of building a game plan. Ooh.
Oh,
and it's just attack after attack now. Bendovsky is doing very well between the sticks to keep this even. I also heard they were sat watching all of our YouTube, so there are pluses and minuses to us doing this kind of thing.
Can we monetize that?
Can we charge other can we charge other teams to watch our stuff?
Yeah, of course. Everything we put out for we put out for free, but I think when it's coaches of other teams, maybe we should be asking them to, you know, chip in a few quid.
Yeah, or they can just send us a video of their boys doing, I don't know, geeky uppies. So we can see how good they are. Just to even the playing field. Having said that, I'm not sure how... Hang on, here comes free kick into the box. But it does get covered up by Bendovsky. I'm not sure how many of the teams in our league do that, because we were, for anybody who might be following this from outside the UK or has just generally been living in a cave, the league has essentially been scratched, so we're going to go back to the equivalent beginning where we were last year. Hang on, Connor, coming through. See... It does get cleared out. So, yeah, so we're going to be back in the Middlesex County Premier League again next season. And I think...
Just to interject there, Martin, you can see in the bottom of the picture, I know you mentioned that the Chipperfield management were getting quite chippy, and I can just see in the bottom of the picture that they are kind of shouting kind of every decision and really scratching their heads as to why their team aren't ahead.
Yeah, I remember I was absolutely shocked that we weren't ahead by this point, but yeah. Any more Chipperfield puns that you can think of, feel free to chuck them in.
There's Jan.
And strike going, yeah. Well wide and over. I mean, was it a strike? Was it a cross? difficult to say on that one. But it is going to go back to bed all clearance.
Just a bit of an update on the hardship fund. We have had a number of donations since the game kicked off, and that has taken us over the £5,000 mark, which is absolutely fantastic. So thanks to everyone for your generous donations and in some cases repeated donations. It means we're able to help a lot of members out, so absolutely fantastic. Over £5,000 is an incredible amount to raise in such a short amount of time. Well done, everyone.
That's brilliant.
That's very cool. Because that was kind of our second target that we set, wasn't it? The first target we set was 1,000, and then we changed it to 5 grand. So, yeah, impressive. Good work, Digitons. I must admit, I've not actually donated this week yet.
Oh, this week? Sorry, okay, fine.
No, I have donated. No, I have done. I've just not done my usual what I would have spent at football donation for this week. Yeah.
You haven't really.
All of the donations. Yeah. All of the donations are going towards Martin's commentary fee. I didn't want to say this on public, but you know that's the secret behind it all.
It all goes into my beer fund.
I thought you spent it on a time machine.
the scientists. Oh, they're just not working hard enough yet. No matter how hard I hit them, they just won't work it out.
Well, if you need any help hitting.
Well, we'll see how we go. I mean, I've said to them, you know, you'll get a Nobel Prize, and, you know, I will let you out of the basement and all this kind of stuff. And, yeah, it's just not helping. Okay, so Tom's coming out on the wing now. Looking for the cross. Looks like it has gone out of her corner, though.
What's going on?
Well, it's corner, isn't it?
Just out of shot.
Yeah. So here it comes, though.
But slightly bizarre clearance there.
Yeah. Knocked up high into the East London sky there, and it's going to be Miller to return it to play. A little bit, yep. It ends up getting knocked down fairly deep into the Clapton half, but it's gonna go for a throw here. So Clapton will just be looking to find someone on the back line here, knock it forward. And it does try and come through to Crosby, but gets cleared up by Chipperfield. Still in Clapton possession here, Ellick, Steph. Coming over to the far side of the pitch, is that Lewis chasing it down? I think that was Lewis it's Lewis on that side of the pitch, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Yeah, but how did he do in that game against Stonewall?
He got two, didn't he?
It was an impressive performance.
He had a great game against Stonewall.
Yeah.
That's an easy one for Vlad, although he's got the sun in his eyes.
He does from this angle, playing down at the BUC end, it can be a bit difficult at this time in the afternoon. Hopefully second half, when he is playing from the clubhouse end, should start getting a little bit easier, particularly as that sun does start getting lower. Oh, sorry, I just picked the names of those ends off the top of my head, the BUC end and the clubhouse end. Feel free to pick alternative names. I should have been more democratic on that.
You are our leader.
Well, we'll go with that for the moment until someone can think of something better, or until some company sponsors the ends. Okay, so Clapton on the back line now, coming up the wing. Not quite able to make anything of it there, though. So, Chipperfield dumping it deep into the Clapton half here. Is just getting bounced around, but none of the Chipperfield players are able to get on the end of it, though, and it does go out for a throw.
They've got two, their centre-backs, both just following Sherwin around. I don't know where the action is, but really kind of a ball over him, basically.
Yeah, I think they must have seen a fair bit of you red. Oh, Chipperfield do have an attempt there, and now it's looking like Clapton on the break. Here they come, several players forward. We've got Steph forward, we've got Sherwin forward. None of them are able to, they aren't able to cross it in. I think maybe Chipperfield have been reading quite a few of the match reports, seeing the man of the match surveys, watching a bit of YouTube. They might see that, kind of Sherwin is our, danger guy. Because, they do seem to be shutting him down quite tight there.
That's true. Martin, we're on about the half-hour mark here. Just wondering how things are going with your watch.
With my watch?
Yeah, you had a bit of trouble, I remember.
Ongoing saga of the watch.
Oh, this is the one that, the wooden watch that I'm whinging about that I've not got.
A wooden watch?
Yeah, it's made of wood.
Watch made of wood?
That's why I wanted it. It looked rustic.
Ah, how does that work then?
But I mean, I'm assuming that the inside bits are metal.
You would hope so.
Yeah. Well, otherwise, I can't see it keeping time if I go out in a moist afternoon or something. That watch still hasn't arrived. But I don't think it has anyway. I've been down in Sussex. I don't know if it's been posted to me, but as far as I'm aware, it's not. I need to get on at them for a refund, and then hopefully we can just draw this whole sorry saga to a conclusion.
It is a sorry saga, mate. You should get on it.
It is, yeah. Consumer nightmare. Free kick coming in. Okay, and it does go over, and we just had producer Paul telling us that the free kick doesn't do anything, so that we didn't have to interrupt our conversation.
Fourth wall.
Oh, it's okay. I refer to producer Paul every now and again.
Precedent. I'm just going to interrupt briefly and say that we've had a few people showing us they're watching the game. Alice Moss tweeting, when Saturday comes, we sit in front of the TV and watch a Clapton CFC classic game. And saying beers and Clapton, can't wait to get back to see. Just watching at home, please do keep tweeting in, and we'll hope to share a few of those later on. Cheers.
When Saturday comes, I've heard of them.
I don't think it was the famous one.
No.
Unfortunately.
Oh, that's a shame. But yeah, so I refer to Paul every now and again because, he's the one who does all the real work, so, yeah, he deserves a name check.
Oh, absolutely. We just sit here talking shite all day. Paul is back there pressing all the buttons and twiddling all these knobs to make this thing happen.
What are you talking about?
Is talking
Hang on,
about the
Chipperfield coming through.
Language. Yellow card for Paul. Another tweet came in. We've got Lisa Matthews in her mermaid legging. It's the week. It certainly is, Lisa. Correct.
Is it just me, or is Joe cutting in and out?
I think Joe's cutting in and out a wee bit. Looking like cans.
Another yellow card on language. Sorry, Paul. Nothing. Am I still cutting in and out?
No, you're sounding okay now. Have another go at reading out that tweet.
No, he's got a potty mouth. He shouldn't be reading anything out.
Lisa Matthews is sitting at home in her mermaid leggings, watching classic Clapton CFC live commentary featuring our Michael. It's the weekend.
Oh,
she says in caps stuff. Thanks, Lisa.
Yeah. There we go. We got there in the end. And while that was happening, Chipperfield had a comp there. They did end up heading it just over the bar, so Vlad is now going to go do a bit more gardening to fetch the ball. Okay, so yeah, we just heard Robert Oxley is suggesting Tisky end for one of the ends of the pitch. I quite like that. Which end? I'm thinking this one with the kind of trees behind it that we're looking at now. Yeah, I think we can have that as a tip.
It's one of the ends south facing, because things tend to go south after too many miles.
I think it would be the end with the clubhouse on it would be south, wouldn't it? I was just thinking more about where most of the cans of Tisky end. yeah, most of them end up in the bush.
The bushy end.
Clapton coming through here, and it is Coleman trying to get into the box, but he is called down for it and he's going to go for a free kick.
Chipperfield throw in.
Here we go, looking for a long throw deep into the dock.
That was a deep one. Still dangerous. Clapton clear it. You can, but it pops back again.
So it's back down Chipperfield end now. That isn't Tellick, is it? That's Sherwin. Trying to chase it down, but not quite able to there. So this is pretty tight match at the moment. I mean, what are we? We must be coming up to about 40 minutes or so. And
Yeah, and
given that these guys have a step above us, yeah, we're punching above our weight on this. Chipperfield coming across the middle now. And there is a strike hit.
Did that hit the
post?
What
did that even hit?
It's a tree.
It looks like it hit a tree, that. Just from the angle that we're looking at here, that looked as though it basically hit the bar and then went straight in. But, yeah, must have just gone wide.
Chipperfield are through again. Oh, Vad's got some fingers. So was that a save?
I believe so.
Is that out for a corner?
Does manage. So the shot has gone wide. It's going to be Bendovsky to return it into play. But I think
he got hands on that personally.
Well, it's going for a goal kick. But yeah, I think he certainly made himself big there just to kind of force the Chipperfield player a little bit wide. Let's say that was Chapman, that one. well, it was either Chapman or Cutler.
Running loose. It's running loose on the left. Picked up.
Oh, just wait. Very wait.
I've had a donation into the hardship fund from Becky the Donkey. So thank you, Becky the Donkey, for your generosity.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh. That's brilliant.
Right. Is Becky the Donkey dead? Will she be able to do that?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I'm assuming that she's not a UK taxpayer. I mean...
Oh! What a save from Vlad!
Lovely save to keep Clapton in the game here late in the first half.
That's fantastic from Bendovsky. He's back from being injured. And it's great to see him back in his first game holding up this way.
Yeah. Very acrobatic for a man who was recently injured. Yeah, as far as I'm aware, the only income Becky the Donkey receives is when I go out in the morning and give her a carrot.
Is that a tie, did you say?
Hang on, I'll tell you after this corner. Okay, so we've got Chipfield here with the corner.
Oh, that was easily cleared.
Yeah, he's going away. No, I meant like a literal carrot. Yeah, I just give a carrot to the donkey.
Probably in there, mate.
Yeah. Well, we end up with loads of critter stories down here. This morning, someone came to our front door with a dog. It's lost. Sherwin.
Oh, and the keeper saved it.
So that was well mocked up there by Bedell.
Probably the first real Clapton chance of the game, I think.
I think that's certainly the best chance they've had so far. Yeah. But yeah, it does get stopped by Bedell. And Corinthians counter-attack. And it somehow doesn't end up in the back of the net. If that had gone in, I'm pretty sure there'd have been a polite applause from the Clapton fans. That would have been a worldie.
Oh, it was a rocket. Best of kick outs from Vlad there. That was one of the things. His injury. Like, oh, Clapton are coming up down the right. Oh!
He just plays it.
So here, late in the second half, Clapton are beginning to string together some chances. That's what, the second chance in as many minutes, having spent large chunks of this first half on the back foot.
We're coming up to the end of the half. We will just resync our various feeds, kind of minimises. Just bear with us if there is any lag. We are trying our darndest to minimise it and have up-to-the-minute commentary for you.
We are doing this in the most high-tech way. We've got like three separate videos all playing, which are different to the video that you're watching. So,
it's crazy.
It's hilarious. I'm very much enjoying it.
We'll also try to stop speaking like Daleks. Corner. Sorry, Martin.
Yep, they're not able to do anything with that, so Chipperfield's still about the 2/3 line. It does get knocked clear by... Is that Smith? No, it's not. It's Yassine. Yassine Rabia manages to knock that clear. Given their kits, do you think Chipperfield Corinthians are part of the City Football Group?
City Football Group.
You know, the sort of the one that Sheikh Mansour has, and he owns like teams all over the place, and he changes all their kit colours
to light blue. Probably not.
I don't know. Maybe he's trying to scout people for lower leagues.
Feeder team.
Yeah, exactly. you go straight from Chipperfield up to Man City.
Yeah, that could happen.
Yeah, I reckon. Well, what's it? What's he called? Jamie Vardy was non-league before he got the England call-up.
Was he?
He was non-league for a long time. I think actually he ended up going to Leicester first and then got an England call-up. But yeah, he was non-league for most of his 20s, I thought.
We can all dream. We can all dream.
No, I've not given up on the idea that I'm going to win an Olympic gold medal at something yet.
Did Chipperfield. You have had a message? I know you've got a lot of fans over there. Rob Ferguson says greetings from Toronto.
Okay, so we have gone for the first half there. It is 0-0 still in this quarterfinals of the Anagram Records Trophy between Clapton CFC and Chipperfield Corinthians FC, the Anagram Derby, as we're calling it. So, sorry, Joe, I interrupted you there. Do you want to just say your bit and then we'll go for our half-time break?
Just seeing you had one of your many writing in saying greetings from Toronto, Canada.
I love Canada.
Bob Ferguson.
Yeah. Yeah. So, while we're going off for, you know, kind of wees and cigarettes and et cetera, if you have not yet donated to the Hardship Fund, it would be great to just chuck in a bit of the money that you would have spent going watching football this week. I personally am going to do it after the match because, well, I don't know, that just works out better for me. But if you can do that, it is really helping people. We have earned over $5,000 so far. So chip in and we'll speak to you in a few minutes.
It's about that time, y'all. Rough Riders. You know, Chuck Long, Eve.
Yo, they wanna know. So I give them hell. Call me misfit, lips for the gang of trash. Riskless now, cause I made a gang of cash. Like glam, still street with the durag. Slang, spit gang, change speech, how they do that? Watch they mouths drop, watch the crowds pop up and act out. Brawls with the school face, smash on and knock out. Ain't chain, ain't no run me, I run the game. If I gotta keep it green, so be it. I'm supposed to change, life simple. Dizzy brawls, they fucking with my mental. Natural born hustling, bitch, check what I've been through. Got mine, took it from you, and now you slot mine. To my own shit, dog. I'm on the job. Cause the image I don't care to be. Realness, real shit, spit reality. Attitude rules, that's the Philly and I. Need me in the game, I'm the thrill in your life. Breath of fresh air, little boys hang me on they wall, I grow them chest hair. Why you listen to other shit, you got the best head. Come on, try your luck, shorty, I got the rest scared. Bet you anything, you ain't ready and you get left there. Ain't known for front and vouch for my behavior. Same way they get down, I get down for this paper. 16, me from my pen, so you protest. I still need to know who I am and cop the record. Take it like a class on me and learn a lesson. Bottom line, my world, my way, any questions? Anyway that I do this shit, I was born to shine, and most of y'all's borderline bullshit. Know exactly what I want for me, you cats is clueless. with dope for the flow through my hands like Waka. Keep stock growing for my son on my tie. Eve wanna own cash, fuck what you bought her. He spin you old, that's what mommy taught her. So hardball is played, won't start the day. Song after song I write so I get paid. Thought I wasn't following up with the second round. Now bitch, swallow it up while I shove it down. Make them love me over again and over your name. Bet you they get over your style and over your fame. Why you looking sad at me? I ain't to blame. Back to plan B, baby, I can feel your pain.
Thank you. Yeah, go ahead.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Yeah. Life is older there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like a breeze. Oh, country road, oh, yeah. Now take me home. Dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, tear up from my eyes.
Now you stop.
Country road, y'all. Country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, my mama, love, take me home. Country road,
let's do that again, y'all.
Country road, take me home to the place.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back for the second half. I hope you had plenty of time to go and do whatever it is that you need to do. Toilets, drinks, donating to a hardship fund, which is very important. So we are in a situation which you don't really get very often at the level that Clapton play, where we are still 0-0 at the beginning of the second half. This is quarter-final of the Anagram Records Trophy. We're playing against Chipperfield Corinthians, who are in the light blue. As I'm assuming that most of the viewers know what the Toms look like. And they are in the league above us, so it is going to be a fight for the Toms. First half probably went more Chipperfield's way than ours, but was reasonably close. Oh, and there's a cross in. So, some early pressure there from the Toms. So, that is the way that things are standing in this game at the moment. By Mike as well. Say hello, Mike.
Oh, hello there, Martin. Yeah.
what?
Aye, okay, so we start the second half. The sun is getting dry. And Chipperfield Corinthians are on the attack now. Hopefully we can hold them off. Ball goes through, edge of the box, Chipperfield are running in, but no, it's blocked. Goes out for a corner for Chipperfield Corinthians.
Yeah, those shadows are getting very long there. I think it might work in favour, actually, playing with the sun on their backs in the second half.
Yeah, we need to put the pressure on and get it up into their goal area more. So, corner coming in. It's whipped good, but Vlad punches, and I think a free kick for Clapton. Short one taken. Too quick.
Is that going back again? Oh, yeah. Yeah,
back
it is.
Back again.
We had a big attendance at this game as well. In the context of the rest of the season, we had a crowd of over 400 for this match, which is pretty respectable at this level. Chipperfield's coach was saying that they typically get about 30 to 40 watching their matches. Chipperfield, not quite able to do anything with that.
Yeah, 427 is the exact the game.
427.
Aye.
Yeah, and that includes me as well. I was there. I've not seen the camera focus on me yet.
That's because you're in the commentary box.
Yes. Hang on, Chipperfield coming over. Not quite able to do that. Yeah. Sorry, I'm breaking the fourth wall again now. Chipperfield had a real chance there, and one of their players punching the ground. How that did not go in, it just kind of trickled down on the right-hand side of the net, but wasn't quite able to get there, and it's going to go for a corner. I think it might have even been Vlad who just knocked that to one side there.
He's had a few good saves today.
Yeah, he is keeping the tons in this at the moment. So here comes corner.
Right, can Clapton do something on the break now? Throw into Clapton.
Sherwin harassing the Sherwin harassing them there. It is now gonna go corner. So we've got Steph coming up forward. A man who is capable of landing a football on a sixpence. So let's see what we can do here. Well, maybe not a sixpence, because I think they probably stopped circulating them before he was got, but a coin of similar size. Okay, corner coming in. Does get punched clear by Bedall. Is that Paul doing some furtive whispering, or is that one of our co-commentators?
Don't know what you're talking about.
Clapton coming into the box here. Still in possession. They are putting some good early pressure on at this point. Now, there was, so from our end in commentary corner, there was some typing and some kind of suspicious sounding whispering. Turns out there was Paul probably doing something incredibly important to keep us online.
The background technical team that we've got.
I love the way that you're saying technical team. I love the way that you're saying, well, firstly, I love the way you're saying technical team just as you cut out, and also technical team when actually we mean Paul.
Paul is an amazing team.
We've got Chipperfield out on the right-hand side, looking for the cross, but aren't quite able to connect. Does stay in play, looking to cross it back in again. Gets knocked out to the two-third line. and it's going to... Okay, so we got Chipperfield. Clapton managed to get this on the path right. So that is Sherwin Stanley there on the wing, manages to cross it into Luis Aredo in the middle of the box, hits it hard and high into the middle of the net. So it is against the run of play early on. It's 1-0. 1-0 to the Toms.
That's a brilliant goal from Lewis. He managed to get in there, lose his marker deep inside the box, and take that ball from Sherwin, slotted at home. Fantastic.
Oh, an amazing one-timer there. And so Clapton do take the lead. What are we now? 7 minutes into the second half.
7 minutes and 40 seconds.
So let's see where Clapton go from here. Are they able to consolidate this lead? Because given the pressure that Chipperfield have been putting them under so far, oh, does get cleared part of the way out. But Chipperfield now coming up the wing, looking for the cross. There's several players in the box. Not able to get anywhere though. Yeah, given the amount of pressure that Chipperfield have been putting on the Tom in this game, you wouldn't think that one goal is going to cut it here. But yeah, that is some good work. And I'm not afraid to say that I'm somewhat surprised. And it looks like we've got a player down on the far side of the pitch. I think that is Albie Miller on his debut here. Just have to wait and see what happens here.
Yeah, that's... This was Albie Miller's first start. Clapton, he came on as a substitute last week, but it looks like he might be in a bit of trouble here. He might have to come off.
Yeah. And now, yeah, you will see that we're all looking at the other end of the pitch. Maybe while Albie's sorting himself out, we can take some... going on 3G. So the red guy. Oh no, yeah, we're back on the correct side of the pitch now. So yeah, Albie's still on the floor there in the corner. Might just give Tom's bit of time here just to have a bit of a breather and yeah, see if they are able to consolidate that lead. But it looks like Miller's gonna be coming off. We've got we look like we're going to be getting a substitution here. As we are waiting for this substitution and Albie to limp his way off the pitch, as we were saying, if you are if you're enjoying the match and you want to perhaps spend some of the money that you would have spent watching real football, but I mean this is real football, but you know what I mean, then yeah, feel free to donate to our hardship fund. We smashed through the £5,000 banner a little bit earlier on in the match. When I looked at half time, we were up to about 5,100. It's all going, but at the moment it's going to members who perhaps need a bit of support for, you know, food, rent, etc. When all of this blows over, if there's anything left in the pot, then I'm sure we'll also find some very good causes for that as well. There's plenty of stuff going on over in East London that, you know, that can require help. So we've got Miller has been taken to the sideline now. He's still down there. It does look like it might be quite nasty. Do you know who number 15 is?
I think it's...
Crossroom. Chipperfield on the edge. Does get cleared by Ben... Well, not cleared. Does get stopped by Bendowski. Sorry, I've interrupted you there.
I think it was Romel Pyle came on there for Albie Miller. Number 14, I think.
He had 15 on his back.
Right.
Yeah, maybe he was playing 15 that day.
This day.
This day. Yeah, this day, present tense. Okay. Cross, coming through. It is Steph in the middle, looking for a bit of space. Not quite able to get there, though. Still in Tom's possession. Has gone for a Chipperfield throw. Chipperfield coach there, you saw at the bottom of the screen, just doing a bit of waving. Is that waving for a substitution? Doesn't look like it right now. Yeah, so there's Clapton throw. Still down there in the corner. Not quite able to see what's happened. It's just off the edge of our vision, but it does look like it's gone for a goal kick.
I think the keeper does have a cap on this time.
A cap?
Can you see a cap on his head?
What you mean, like, as in sort of like those really old school keepers that you saw in like Roy the Road stuff?
Well, when the sun's this low in a February afternoon, right in your eyes.
I suppose, yeah, it does make sense having something, particularly when you're playing from what will possibly now be called the Tisky end of the pitch. It probably does help. It just looks very old school.
Some of the old school rules still apply.
Yeah.
I don't think you can call it the Tisky end, though, because, I mean, every end's a Tisky end, surely.
No, I thought so. So Clapton coming up the middle. There is a cross. I mean, it does get knocked in, but yeah, it's getting called down for offside. Is that offside? So yeah, we think that's just been called down for offside, unfortunately.
No, it's been
It's getting called for a throw-in, and we do now have a Chipperfield substitution as well happening. So looking to, I think their squad will have tired themselves out a fair bit in that first half. A lot of running around, a lot of pressure, and I think so far Clapton have been able to.
That's a good ball in the middle.
Coming through. Not quite able to do anything with that though. I think Clapton are managing to tire them out here.
Chipperfield are right through. Edge of the box for Chipperfield, and it's blocked. Brilliant. Throw in,
and there's Albie at the bottom of the screen. You can see he is being helped back to the Tom's bench, so yeah, that is going to be the end of his afternoon.
Yeah, he wants to get an ice pack on that, I think.
If I remember rightly, yeah, he spent most of the rest of the afternoon with one on his foot. Did eventually make him into it, though.
He probably will, Martin, yeah.
So we've got the throw now coming in. Chipperfield's still on the edge there, but it is now gone for a free kick. Still looking for that insurance marker here, just to have the lead out a little bit. Let's see if we can get something on the break.
Chipperfield have had a few good attacks. This game is not over.
They have.
And that's out for a throw-in for Clapton. Halfway into the Chipperfield half. Nice bit of juggling there. And I think that's gone Chipperfield's way.
Yeah, you will. Yeah, you will have to excuse us when things go into the corners, because these were static cam. Well, were our static cam.
And it's out wide for Clapton. And just wide of the post.
Does just go to the left of goal there. And who was it who got on the end of that? Was that? It looks like that might have been Stanley who got on the end of that and just tried to head it home, but does just go on the wrong side of the post. Chipperfield clearing out pretty low there, a bit of a scuff, and Clapton are able to take advantage of it on the break.
That was a poor, poor kick out from the goalkeeper there.
that might be the most Scottish thing I've ever heard.
That was poor.
I do also like the way that we've got... Oh, hang on. Here come Clapton breaking out. Oh, it's coming across.
Oh, close one.
Just get covered by Bedon.
That was a really, really good chance for Clapton there. The keeper did well.
It's some nice little heel work there from the from the Chipperfield player to keep it in possession in the middle. Clapton just trying to grind it down now into the Chipperfield half. And there is a bit of space in the box.
Offside.
Not quite able to get there. And yeah, goes for offside. You know what I'm saying? It is kind of amusing that we're all sat here watching an East London football team with two Northerners and a Scot doing the commentary.
We are an internationalist brigade.
We are, very much so, yeah. As our friend in Toronto will attest.
Aye.
I think we've been having quite a lot of chat with Tanya, with it being the anniversary of was it the anniversary of the end of the Civil War, beginning of the Civil War? I can't remember.
The shirt was to commemorate the end of the Civil War. Oh, that was a well taken by Blair there.
I know the shirt. Yeah, what was 14th of April? I mean, Chipperfield still out on the edge of the box here, just returning to the game quickly. And it does get knocked over onto the 3G. What is... Producer Paul there helping me out. 14th of April was the proclamation. Yeah, was the proclamation of the Spanish Republic. That's why we've been having a fair bit of interaction with our Spanish comrades over the last week.
Okay, Chipperfield still pressing down on the left wing there. Clapton holding them back though. And it's out for a Clapton throw.
You might have noticed, by the way, that Joe has been suspiciously quiet. I think his computer has dropped out, well, we're pretty sure it has, or he's just off, aren't they? Plotting, but let's assume his computer's down.
Got a little message from him saying his computer was still beeped.
I like the way you self-censored on that. We've already got my kind of yellow card here. Language that the kiddies shouldn't be hearing, so.
Shocking.
No, no. And apart from anything, being Scottish, it kind of impinges on your culture to not be allowed to to use certain words.
How dare you? Right, that was a good save again for Flavio. I'll see you later, pal.
I'm sure you will. Yeah. in the what's it called? Is it the Glasgow Kiss when you head up?
You should be so lucky. You should be so lucky.
No, okay, fine. It will just be a kick in the balls.
Right. So, what's happening with the football here over on the far side?
There's going to be a Chipperfield throw here.
It's a Clapton throw coming out of the fence.
Yeah, no, Clapton throw, yeah.
Oh, stole a good 10 yards there, that was good. And here goes Clapton through the middle.
In the middle of the park.
Oh, now it's chipped over the top.
Is that going to get called down for offside?
That was offside. It's a nice little chip, but just not the right timing.
So we've got a, someone wanting a shout out from Tasmania.
Tasmania?
Robert Oxley. Yeah, wow. We do get people from all over the world. What time is it in Tasmania? Hang on, Chipperfield coming up, looking to just try and get the ball into the box. And Clapton looking to clear. They do manage to do that. I have a good friend who's from. I went over to visit. Bloody hell, probably about 10 years ago now. I do like Tasmania. I think that's my favourite bit of Australia. But yeah, good to have you on board.
Right, still a bit of tussle in the midfield here, but Chipperfield through on the right. Ball's whipped in and whipped out again. Stefan Nielsen there just came up to Uncle Stu to pick up a piece of fruit.
Was that fruit? What's he going to do with the skin or the core? Whatever.
He's Stefan Nielsen, he eats the whole.
I think we lost you there, Mike.
Stefan Nielsen, he don't care about skins or cores.
Just eats it whole.
Yeah.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, we had a dog delivered to our... which got lost, and I was saying, well, we'll keep
what?
It till. No. This is related. It was a lost dog, and I was saying we'll hang on to it till about 10 p.m. and then sell it to the kebab shop.
Martin.
In terms of things, people will eat anything. Kebab shops.
Right. Anyway.
What, you don't think they've got dog in those kebabs?
I'm a vegetarian, Martin. Right.
Yeah, I'll believe that they source that from, actual kebabs. When pigs fly. So we've got,
Elliot's down here. I think maybe he's just having a wee rest. Quite a lot.
Yeah, it's going to go for a free kick, so we've got Steph Nielsen. And he's going to be looking to hit it deep into the Chipperfield half here, just to try and make it two, and essentially put 1 foot through the door, semi-final.
Yeah, we could do it
long
another
and
goal.
Deep.
It's easy for the keeper in the end.
I should say that the dog was very cute and the owners came to pick it up. So, there was a happy ending to the story.
That was good. Clapton through in the middle again here. And that goes out for a corner. Clapton still keeping up the pressure in the second half. We've got that one goal, but could do with another.
So Shadow's lengthening here across the dog as Steph sets up for his corner.
It's a long one. Back in.
Oh, landed.
I mean, just landed on top of the bar.
I don't think you can even say that hit the bar, it just trickled over it. And the Chipperfield coach there getting very animated about just about their defence. Because if Clapton get another goal, then you'd think at this stage of the game Chipperfield might be out of.
Okay, so another corner coming in. What's that? A wee bit of a stramash in the penalty area. Yeah, a bit of a rally going on there, but I think the ref's on top of it now.
It's like a Brammy.
Brammy.
Clapton. Not quite.
And it's cleared again. Clapton are really putting on the pressure in the staff.
They really are at this stage. For our international fans, do you want to translate Brammy into standard English?
It's a Rammy, a bit of a Barney, you know, a Stramash, that kind of thing.
A Barney and a Mash, because that's really helpful. I think what...
Oh, that was perfect, the keeper and Clapton around.
And it...
Again.
It is
that was too tight.
Not quite able to do it, but they are still there. Looking here for the cross, out on the edge of the box. But it still gets swept up by Bedell.
Is that out for another corner?
It's looking like it. I thought Bedell had that there, but he must have picked it up from the other side of the line.
That's about four corners.
There is a lot of pressure coming here now.
Oh! Off the bar! What's that? That was a stramash.
So that is again off the bar.
Oh, Chipperfield on the break, but Clapton managed to run it past two defenders.
There is a lot more pressure now coming from the boys in red and white, and it's surprising. It's just the game has turned on its head at the moment. From Chipperfield being the ones with kind of all the offensive pressure, it's just completely turned around.
Yeah, I think we're seeing Clapton in the ascendancy now. They sense victory and they really...
Oh, they look like the better team, and for large chunks of that first half, it was surprising that Clapton were still managing to stay in this, but it is... Yeah, it's certainly going the Tom's way now. Yeah, I think we do tend to play a bit better in the second half. Personally, I call it Jeff time. Where he definitely starts scoring a whole bunch of goals in the second half.
Yeah, we've done a lot of that coming back in the second half. There's certainly more confidence this half. More togetherness in the first half.
I think part of it is just you just knacker the other team out and then...
Oh, that's a great ball through at the middle.
Coming through.
Oh, offside again.
But still some good offensive pressure from the Toms here. Just need to try and stay on the right side of that line. And the coach of Chipperfield still getting incredibly animated there. It will be a disappointment for Chipperfield if they end up losing this. We've got another sub here, so that was Coleman coming off, I think. Yeah, so let's say it was Coleman. So it was Jamal coming on, we think, and we think it was Coleman coming off. And because this is a one-way channel, there's nobody to contradict us. Okay, Bob, coming through. Not quite able to get there.
That ball has just whipped too far over. But that's not a very confident defence by Chipperfield there, just hoofing it away out for a throw-in.
They are starting to look a bit rattled, these guys, now.
I think they are. They're looking a bit shaky. I mean, we've had quite a few chances here. And now we've got this throw-in. It's back for the cross.
Through! Nobody able to get a good connection there.
And it, we're still fighting for it. Clapton are still fighting for it.
Yeah, so it's still out on the wing here. It's just gone off the edge of shot. I think it is a Clapton throw.
Looks like it.
Yeah, so we've got a Clapton throw.
Oh, a long one into the middle. Got on this. It's broken for Chipperfield, but no, Clapton have mopped it up in the middle. Oh, nice. He's threw it out on the right for Clapton. Can he whip it in? Into the middle.
Oh! Oh. There have been some rocket shots on that end of the pitch. I don't know whether they're trying to knock thinkers. Well, they're certainly not hitting the goal, but that was another absolute laser.
Yeah, and you're getting closer.
And you also saw the Chipperfield coach there yelling again, which I like. It is funny watching an opposition coach getting annoyed.
Yeah, I think they are a bit rattled. So there's about 15 minutes to go in this half. That's a dangerous ball into the box. Clapton whack it away. I think we could definitely see another goal. They're really pushing at it, but they've got to be careful in the Chipperfield break, I think.
Yeah, time is running short here for the Corinthians to get back into this.
Oh, that was a dangerous challenge on Nielsen there.
And there is going to be a minor debate, and then Nielsen now has an opportunity here to put in a delivery and put this game to bed. Well, you'd hope put the game to bed. No, and it ends up going straight off a Corinthian head and getting knocked back down the park.
Clapton giving it away again there. Still quite a tussle down this there left hand.
Yeah, we've certainly been looking at the trees a lot more often than.
Yeah, the game's been much more in Clapton's attack this half. Right, we've got a bit of a hold up here. Got a sore ear. He's got attention to his ear. He's got his earring. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it looks like an earring. I didn't realise they let footballers wear it.
He just had it done in Claire's accessories. Well, it seems some referees do not take too kindly to people wearing earrings. Stefan Nielsen in the middle.
Stefan, he's onside.
He's still onside. It's a long ball from Liam Smith. Bang! Wide.
Look, looks like we have another... No sub there for Chipperfield. It's just 11 going for a bit of a chat. So Chipperfield's clear. The coach yelling something at them there. And it is another really quite poor goal kick there.
He's not very good at those. He's scuffed.
He's not. I mean, you know, even as a man who has no hand-eye coordination, I would think that I could do better than that. But there you go. Think, yeah, think being the important word in that. But no, I've definitely kicked a ball further than that.
I don't know, it's easy for us sitting up here in the commentary box looking down on this this arena to put ourselves in their place, but they're under quite a lot of pressure in this quarter final of the Anagram Records Trophy here.
Well, you don't get much bigger than the Anagram Records Trophy. Brilliant delivery in from the free kick.
So that is
free kicking from Nilsson. Brilliant hit into Elliot. Get knocked home by Sherwin Stanley. And that does give Clapton the cushion. Two goals to nil here in the quarterfinals.
It was a really well taken goal for Sherwin to put it in. But I mean, you've got to look at the chip defence there. They left him completely unmarked.
That was amazingly linked up. And did you also, did anybody else on the left-hand side just see a toddler run? Yeah, that was... yeah. That was... I know, that was, also an amusing distraction as the toddler ran pitch.
Yeah, he stamped that out of football.
So, we certainly do.
Oh, Chipperfield again. The ball is skied and the arms...
Nowhere near. So, yeah. Chipperfield have the bit between their teeth here.
I think Clapton have the bit between their teeth.
Maybe just... What does the bit between their teeth mean?
That means that you're racing forward like a thoroughbred racehorse.
Okay, I never realised that. I thought the bit between your teeth was... like similar to having your back up against the wall.
No. They're quite the opposite. Clapton have got a bit between their teeth. They're racing forward. Nothing's going to hold them back. I wouldn't be surprised if they get another goal.
Okay, well, yep. Oh, okay. Well, there you go. So, Clapton have the bit between their teeth and Chipperfield have the back against the wall.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, no. I never realised that had to do with horses.
I thought living in the countryside with donkeys and all that, you would...
Yeah, but I'm scared of horses.
Oh, yeah, they are quite scary. That's a long throw into the middle of the box.
Well, so Paul's just asked to hear a bit more about my... not a whole lot more to say about it. It's just they're big and they kick.
Horses. Yeah.
I just don't like horses. I like donkeys. Donkeys are manageable.
We've established that.
Yeah. And llamas. I don't mind llamas.
Alpacas?
Alpacas. Yeah, actually, we've got some alpacas in the next field. And they're quite friendly. Yeah, it's just the horses I'm not fans of.
Amazing. Now, just seeing the Chipperfield's got their defender back to take the goal kick rather than the goalkeeper. I wonder if he's having a bit of trouble with his foot.
It's either a bit of trouble with his foot or it's a bit of a psychological thing that he's just done a few bad kicks and, yeah, doesn't feel capable of doing it anymore, maybe. We've got Steph now with another free kick in a very similar position to where we got that goal. Several minutes ago. So let's see if we can get a repeat performance here.
That last one, he pinged it right into the box.
So there are a few Clapton players forward. I mean, no reason to push absolutely everybody up at this stage. Here it comes.
Sheridan Stanley. What a goal.
Beautiful. Sherwin heading it. Gets knocked down off the bar.
That was an amazing free kick. Look at that, right in there. Boom.
That has two finished games. That is 3-0 now from the Toms.
There's no way they're coming back from this.
No, there's absolutely not.
Just under the bar, that's great.
And I've said this before in previous commentaries, and I'm going to keep repeating it. It's just so hard to find a player who is that good with the dead ball at this level, who's just able to, just drop it on someone's head like that.
Yeah. There's Clapton on the attack again, going through the middle. It's chipped over to the wide right. Got a chance for a shot. Line it up.
Yeah, still in there. Can they make it four?
Just took a little too many touches. Oh, yeah, he's pulling his jersey there. Oh, Elliot.
By the way, if we are under lockdown for quite a long period, we'll at some point pick a game where we lose. Because otherwise, there's not going to be suspense. But, at the moment, we are marching on to the semi-final. Paul's just said, hang on. Chipperfield, looking for a consolation. Not able to get it. Paul just said, the ones where we lose get deleted. So, yeah, it might just be a greatest hits compilation over the next few weeks.
So Clapton still holding on to the ball at the halfway mark. It's chipped over the top for the Chipperfields.
Just as they were going off camera there, that did like a bit of a shove. It looks like, so it's going to be a Chipperfield free kick or a throw. I mean, it's difficult to say. Pretty sure it's Chipperfield free kick here. Okay, so, we've also had a Mr. S. Stanley of London saying that the third goal was very good. What a goal, precisely. That could be anybody.
Could be anybody.
It could.
Just a coincidence, I'm sure.
Yeah. Well, it's nice to have you on board, Mr. S. Stanley, whoever you are.
I mean, the header was okay. It was just that wonderful free kick that put it there. And, obviously...
I think that's it. I mean, Mr. Stanley, all he had was just stand there and bounced off his bounce.
Yeah, that was it.
Yeah.
But, it was good of him to be in that position, bounce off the bone.
Yeah. I mean, someone else probably told him to stand there.
cheeky little chip there from Clapton. Can they get one more at the end? It's in the middle. Oh, and he's...
Sorry, Sherwin, we do love you, really.
That's Mr. Sherwin to you.
Oh, yeah, sorry, Mr. Stanley. So Clapton really pushing for a fourth goal. Just had a couple of good attempts there, and it has gone into the bush for a fan to retrieve.
I think we must be into... Are we into added on time yet?
We're definitely deep into extra time. My bladder says that this is nearly done.
A bit too much information. Goes out for a throw-in. No, kick. A bit of a shoulder charge. So, right at the death, Chipperfield have got one more free kick. Can they get a consolation goal?
Go on, Chipperfield, and your hilarious Comic Sans and Man City. Get a bit of consolation.
I know it's going over to the wide left. Is it too wide? Can Clapton mop it up? Yes. Wins it. Keeps possession. Whacks it up to the halfway line. Oh, lovely little. Yeah. And is he through? He's running through in goal. There's two of the Clapton players. Oh, and it's just blocked in the middle of the penalty area. And Chipperfield trying to move it up the park again. And that is the final whistle.
There we go.
Penalty three.
It's all over.
Chipperfield Corinthians nil.
Yeah. Clapton win 3-0. Brilliant clean sheet there for Vlad Bendovsky. And there you can see all of us having a bit of a cheer. So, yeah, that was, good result there. And we march on to the semi-final, where we will end up playing against Ware FC. Where is Ware? Well, I know you'll have to find out at some point. Right, so, yeah, thank you very much for joining us for another classic Clapton. Hope we've managed to keep you diverted from the horror that has become our reality for a couple of hours. If you have enjoyed it, well, even if you haven't, then you should donate a bit of money to our hardship fund. Just whatever you dispense at the football today. Right, so I think that does it for me. Any extra words from you, Mike?
Oh, that was just an honour to be in the Cup today and watch that great victory. And we look forward to the next round of the Cup. Thank you very much, everybody. Over and out from Archie McPherson.
Yep.
Everybody dance, clap your hands. We'll be right back.